Hello everyone, welcome back to another podcast, hashtag DSG podcast. Today we are talking about adaptation of students in different country, not just student but anyone in a different country. What are the experience, what are the things you can, which are important for you, which you can keep in your mind, what can help you, what cannot. In this podcast, I invited my friend Sweta to talk about this thing and okay. She is Sweta. Sweta, welcome.
Hi.
She is Svetlana. Her short name is Sweta, so we say her Sweta. She is a psychology student. She will be a clinical psychologist after 1 year, yes?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm not wrong, yeah. So technically we are classmates. I invited her to talk on this topic about the adaptation of a person in another country or a student, medical student from India in Russia or Russian living in India or traveler, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So what do you want to say or how do you want to start? Because I don't want to ask you some question but just want to know your opinions.
Well,
what is the most important thing? Yes.
Can I say that I prefer to divide adaptation on two points: physical
adaptation,
aspects,
yes,
of adaptation, and mental aspects.
Yeah.
Physical aspects may include climate, geography, I can explain it, and traditions that, things that relate to traditions, for example, clothing, food.
You mean like the local culture of that place?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, okay.
And geographical adaptation means that you have to find some place, go to the shop, go to the library, to the university, use local transport, use the map, know the streets names, etc.
Yeah, so you want to say like there's a physical adaptation, there is a mental adaptation, and physical you have to get inside the culture of the place, learn about traditions.
Yes, so when you are still in your motherland, you can use Google to read about cities where are you planning to go. For example, watching some list of places that you can see. What else? Well, maybe read some history of this place, read some news about things that happened there.
Yeah, I understood. So technically these are the factors for physical adaptation. What about the mental adaptation?
Well, I guess it's a language. It's the first point. And mentality in general.
Yeah, like my question is like how to understand the mentality of people, like what do you think? Is it even necessary to understand the mentality of people, or you can survive without it?
Of course you can survive. But the quality of this survival will be lower.
Yeah, you are right.
Worse, how to say it in a proper way.
Like you will, your life will be miserable, I guess.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
Well.
Yeah.
Are there some ways to know the mentality?
There are.
For example.
For example, like with my experience, I think just to be friends, go on the streets, try to watch people, try to see about their habits, notice little things, you know, and you can find out about a lot of characters about different persons, but it will take time. You will not understand someone's character or someone's this culture or mentality in one day. Mentality is a big word, you know. It can change also.
Yes.
Yeah, my mentality changed a lot when I was in India. Now I'm here. After 6-7 years, my mentality changed a lot.
Well, there is, how to say it, individual mentality and nation mentality.
Civil mentality, like society's mentality.
Yes. Individual mentality, it's better to call it psychological particularities, character, way of thinking. Well, maybe it's mentality also.
Yeah, yeah. So let's talk about adaptation again. According to you, we have to adapt physically and mentally. According to me also, we have to adapt physically and mentally. with my experience, how I adapt in Russia, how I survived all these 6 years from when I came, you know, I was like not prepared.
Mm-hmm.
I was.
I saw your previous podcast with Amit and Somesh about your first day here in Russia.
Did you understood something?
Tora.
Okay.
A little bit.
She's learning Hindi. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's about physical, you know, I knew already that it will be cold
yes.
And I had a weak immunity to cold, so
mm-hmm.
cold was a big stress for me all the time, even for my family. They
mm-hmm.
were like, how will you survive if something happens? Just don't hide it, just say it to us
mm-hmm.
and we are always there for you. Even they even said me like, you know, there is this stereotype, and even a lot of people do these things, that if you are living in a very cold place, for example Russia, have a sort of vodka when you feel cold and it will be fine. And actually it happens, it's a stereotype actually, but
mm-hmm.
it works sometimes. Yeah, even my family told me, if you need it, you can do it, just don't make yourself addict to it. So In this case, they were very open to me. Okay, I will not speak about family and all these things in this adaptation. But yeah, they told me like not to have barriers around me, not to isolate me from something. If I need to do something for myself to adapt, do it. For them, it was like, just don't affect your studies in any way. You want to eat something? Go for it. You want to drink something? Go for it. You want to have a new habit? Go for it. Just don't do crimes
mm-hmm.
don't affect your studies, you know, in a like healthy way. They were allowing me to do, and it was also mentally encouraging for me
mm-hmm.
for that time. I was like, oh, my family's not against anything
mm-hmm.
so I will not think twice doing something which is not. I never did something, for example. So it helped me a lot. It gave me a lot of confidence that time, and I was always like ready to do adventure from the first year also. And but about the language,
mm-hmm.
very important thing. If you're going
yes.
to some place where you can't speak the language, it is everything. 50% of your adaptation depends on the language.
Yes, if you don't know the geography, if you don't know anything about food, money, you can ask someone.
At least, yeah.
About it. Ask for help,
yeah.
for advice.
Yeah. But I'm not saying that don't go to some place if you can't speak the language of that place. Go to that place, try to learn something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because when we came zero in case of language. We were not aware of anything. Like we didn't know anything in Russian language. We came here, we started classes, we learned. And with my experience, I think the only way to learn a language is to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
You can learn grammar, you can learn everything from the books, but unless you speak, you can't like express yourself.
Yes.
Yeah.
And may I give an advice according to it? Maybe this is the main advice
mm-hmm.
That before going anywhere, you should watch some videos, some tutorials,
vlogs,
lessons of a language of that country. Where are you going? For
yeah.
example, some simple words like hi, thank you, where is this library?
Yeah.
Who's
no, Google Translate is always there for you, but still, it's not.
It's
internet
much
is always. Yeah,
talk.
It's better to talk and communicate. You're right.
Mm-hmm. For example, I saw a lot of videos about people who came to India, and when someone wants to buy something and
mm-hmm.
asks the price or something else in English, the price is 2 or 3 times higher than if you ask for the price in Hindi, for example. It's also
yeah.
a good thing.
No, you know, it you are right. It happens in India a lot of time.
I guess Russians also can do such things.
Of course.
Not in a market with fixed prices, but in bazaar. We also call it bazaar.
Yeah, bazaar is bazaar.
Russian.
In Russian also, and in Indian also, bazaar.
Mm-hmm.
Bazaar is bazaar. So
in English?
Market.
Yeah. Okay.
I never experienced such thing because, you know, when we were like new to this place,
mm-hmm.
so our teachers were always there for us. They used to help us. Even we made some few friends, they helped us a lot.
Mm-hmm.
They used to go with us to different places. They introduced us to different places, different shops which are good and cheap, and they helped.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
It's because you had teachers, but when someone comes to some country as a tourist,
yeah,
or he's got a job in another yeah. country and he has no teachers who can help.
Yeah, internet is always there for them. Learn language, find something. There are different apps available. You know, a lot of people ask me how to learn Russian language. I can say like if you are alone, you don't have a teacher, just go for internet, find a different website, download some material. There are a lot of books available, just at least Google. A lot of people just came to me, send me something to learn Russian language.
Mm-hmm.
So I find it so lazy for them. They just can't type Russian language books, and the first 10 links are mm-hmm. the books PDFs. Just go and download them. Mm-hmm. It's the easiest process they can do. Because me, like I usually don't reply to such messages. I try to ignore because I think if a person can't even search a book for them, why will they read it in the
Agreed.
First place?
Agreed.
Yeah. So what, like mentally, a lot of students get depressed. A lot of people
mm-hmm.
start feeling homesick. How to get over these things? How to survive this phase? What can help?
As a medical student,
yeah,
I can say that the reasons of this depression are not only mental things. You know, depression begins because of lack of some vitamins, because of the weather particularities. When there is no sunlight, you don't receive vitamin D.
Yeah,
that's also one of important things. And well, you can talk to your family every day in Skype or in other messengers, Facebook, etc.
Yeah.
Well, of course it's difficult to leave everything that you had and go to absolutely another place. This fast changes mm-hmm. May cause depression. Yes, it is. That's why I'm giving you the second advice. I don't know how to say it.
Say in Russian, I will help.
Вот когда все меняется очень быстро,
uh-huh.
Ты должен делать, чтобы по чуть-чуть менялось.
You have to start with small changes and then...
Yes.
With small...
For example, for the first month when you are in another country,
uh-huh.
you can call your family a few times a day. The next month, call them once a day. The next month, call them once a week.
Yeah,
and it relates to everything, not only to communication.
It means like start changing, like start adapting to new environment slowly.
Yes, slowly.
Not at once.
Yeah.
It's right, absolutely right. Because we also studied in psychology when we were studying mm-hmm. that if you are not able to survive or the change, break it into parts. Now, change few things.
Mm-hmm.
Then change after like 20 or 20 days or a month, change few more things or habits,
yes.
and slowly you will adapt.
Mm-hmm.
It will take time. Time is everything. Time helps. Yeah, for physical adaptation,
it's the same.
Yeah.
For example, eat your home food for some time, then add other meals.
Yeah, I want to add in this thing that for the food thing. If like you can cook, try to cook something like from your homemade recipes,
yeah.
And like we cook Indian food every day,
mm-hmm.
we don't eat Russian food every day. I eat Russian food in restaurants outside a friend's house and everywhere, so I don't get bored of Indian food all the time. Plus I also get chances to eat Russian food. It's interesting for me and for you also, maybe. Yeah. Like if you are in different place, you try the local food, but you don't eat three times, yeah?
Actually, after 12
mm-hmm.
years, I've never been to other countries, so I...
From the age of 12?
I can't say the... Yes.
I wish you will go to some other country soon.
I will go, I promise.
Yeah.
To myself and to everyone.
Okay, so, you know, I want to talk about this, that... when I came, it was a surprise for me.
Mm-hmm.
I never decided to go to another country, and suddenly circumstances become like this that I came to Russia. So I was not prepared. It was like a time of 2 months,
mm-hmm.
this lot, and everything happened in this time. And I ended up in Russia. So most of people are not like ready for this, and if such situations happens to them, what to do? In your point, yeah.
By the way, there's a phrase for it, cultural shock.
Cultural shock.
Да.
Yeah.
It's a phrase that we normally use in Russia in that case. Well, the advice is, if you are planning to go to some other country with a totally different culture, it's not a good idea, actually. You should visit some other countries with a culture that is a little bit similar with your country's culture. So it's the same thing, just change, let it change slowly. For example, if you are from India, go firstly to, I don't know, Cambodia, Vietnam, after that to Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and after that to Russia.
Perhaps, but you know, like I want to add over here that like it's not impossible that you can't survive, yeah? Even the, like India and Russia are different places, different worlds. India is something else, Russia is something else. If you talk about food, about weather, about people, a lot of things change. And it's a completely different environment, and it's not bad, it's good. So when I was here for the first time, I started observing a lot. Like I was not so active, but we tried to do things whenever we got time. Even my friend circle, they were like adventurous people. And like I'm thankful to them that I have such friends from the first day. They were adventurous. And we started understanding each other's mind quickly, and we made a lot of adventures together. And even like we were on the street on the second day only, me with my two friends. So we were on the street searching for the McDonald's, and we ended up in a burger shop, and we tried like we were eating burger. So it was the first time Indians were on the Soviet Sky Street. We were not like able to speak in Russian, so we were speaking in English. We found a couple, like they were able to understand English, but they were not able to speak. So we were asking for McDonald's. It's like McDonald's in Russian also. And such small incidents happened a lot, and we learned from them. Right now, I saw a lot of people like they are afraid to express themselves. Maybe they are shy. They are not afraid. Maybe they are shy. I am mistaken, but it feels like they're not able to speak. They don't want to speak sometimes, and they don't want to have that adventure, or they don't want to feel that. Sometimes you know you live in a strict climates or like strict situations. You're not habitual, but unless you open yourself, you try to do it once. How will you learn? So a lot of people lack these things, in my experience. So I will say that. Don't be conservative, open yourself, take challenges, small challenges, and they will tell you a lot of things. And speak up, go and speak, no one is judging you. People will like if you speak their languages, and it is the only way, it is the only way.
Yes, yeah? Don't isolate.
Do not isolate yourself, feel it, like have adventure, learn something new every day. Yeah, what else?
Have you read something about Russia before you came here?
No, I will tell you why. Because I used to live in a village, and I had like this phone, small phone, and I also had internet, but it was 2G. And where I was living, the 2G was like not even working as 2G, so it was very slow. And I had like a small time. When I decided, oh, I have to go to Russia to study now, I didn't even had a passport. I didn't have even had a birth certificate, which is very necessary document that time. So first I went to make my certificate, then I went to make my passport, and all of these procedures I did myself with my friend. So I used to travel a lot making all these documents, going to different government offices, begging them most of the times. I even gave bribes a few times, because it was not my mistake. They were not doing it, so I had to do something. So I gave, like I wanted it as soon as possible in my hands. So I'm sorry for that. And so in 2 months, I did everything. I made my passport, I like then got visa, applied everything, paid fees, and then came over here in 2 months. Even I was the first batch in this university. So I was happy. I was confident because my family was supporting me everywhere. Second thing, I was doing everything and learning everything. Before that, I was isolated at my house. My I was not doing something big in my life.
Mm-hmm.
I was a common student going to school, learning tuitions, but I wanted to experience life. And then I got this chance because I was doing everything myself, traveling alone. So I found this, I can do this. And it motivated me. So I was enjoying this phase. Then came over here, so it was very different place. Like I was little bit shy in first, and I'm always like this. So I'm shy, then start open, and then open a lot. So my experience was good.
Mm-hmm.
I experienced a lot, and I'm thankful for that.
I think it's because you didn't think that going to other country is a torture, that it's something difficult. You had no fear. You thought that it's gonna be an adventure, but not a torture. How to
agree? Actually, yes. I never thought it will be a torture for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because I never had this thought in my mind that it's a torture for me, or I was never afraid that if I didn't study MBBS or if I didn't survive medical study, what will happen to me? It was never in my mind. And if I think about it and recall everything, I don't know why. Maybe I was it was my first time I was experienced life.
Mm-hmm.
I was going places to places, meeting new people. And I was so busy learning life that I forgot about all these worries.
About fear.
So, yeah, it happened to me. Right now, I think a lot about future, about past and all these things, and I don't like it when I get stressed and in this sometime depression and all these things. So I don't like it. That time was good because that time I was not afraid of anything, but I was doing everything so nicely, observing everything, enjoying, thanks to all the people around me. That time they helped a lot, they taught a lot. Yes.
Kya bolu? What to say? Well, in conclusion,
mm-hmm.
I can say that there are a few things you can do before going to other country to get adapted faster and better. Firstly, it's Google. Read something about this place,
YouTube.
Where you're going. No, YouTube vlogs.
Subscribe to my channel if you want to come to Russia.
Yes. The second is make the changes slowly, not very fast. And don't be afraid, I think.
And speak a lot.
Yes, speak.
Speak a lot. Have adventure. Yeah?
Yes. Subscribe. Like kijiye. Or... kya bolu? Pichle videos dekhiye. Pichle?
Pichle, yeah. Pichle
purane. Pichle videos dekhiye.
Thank you very much. Dhanyavaad. Okay. So on this note, we are ending this video. I hope you like this podcast. Please like, subscribe, and watch pichle videos.
Dekhiye.
Yeah. See you again in next video.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I had to say, phir milenge.
Say. Say it now.
Phir milenge, dosto.
Yeah.